Epic Games are known around the world for creating the Unreal Engine, and they're always interesting people to talk to, so we did, to find out how their technology has permeated the world of video games.
So it's bigger, it's crazier, but you guys obviously created the Unreal Tech to kind of help developers sort of get through this next generation and every consistent generation.
One thing I figured out, Unreal Engine 3 has shipped more titles on PlayStation 3 than any other technology. And you know it's a relatively new platform. It's only been around now for a year. And so the good part is this is a great year because we're seeing a lot of the fruits of our and our licensees' labors, right?
Do you guys have a count on how many people are using Unreal Tech right now?
No, we've never really sat down and counted them all. The problem is, the reason we almost try to avoid it is a lot of our licensees will be doing titles, they haven't announced them yet, and so we just want to, we let them make their announcements.
And I know you guys hate when people say this, but there is a kind of a look that you can kind of associate with some of the Unreal Tech. Are you guys working with developers to kind of try to get every game that goes out there to have a different kind of vibe and spin?
It's a misconception.
Yeah.
We sell canvas, paint, and paintbrushes.
Yeah.
What you do, or the licensee, the client does with that tool set is their own.
Yeah.
They can make a masterpiece, as we've seen. They can do anything they want. Most of our clients are very successful with it. They don't have to make the standard first-person shooter. We've got games, wide-open, big-world games like APB, All Points Bulletin, MMO games.
Agency is a cartoon-style, doesn't look anything like Unreal.
Yeah.
Undertow, which Microsoft just
gave
out.
That was cool, actually. Cool seeing game. That on Xbox Live Arcade and seeing that the Unreal...
There's no limits.
But there's nothing inherent about the tools that's going to make the games look the same. And you have so much customization possibility with Unreal Kismet. Like I say, you can make your game look completely different. I mean, BioShock doesn't look like Unreal Tournament 3.
True.
Outside of, Unreal, outside of Gears of War, what's one of your favorite Unreal Tech games? I know you're going to piss off a whole... No, come on.
You want us to pick
No, come on. You guys play all the... You're gamers.
All our children.
So gross. And you're Democratic and Republican at the same time.
I mean, it's pretty obvious. BioShock
is your game?
It's pretty amazing.
We got a game.
It's a great game.
We got a game name. That's cool. It is an amazing game.
I think everybody in the industry agrees it's a great game. And it's different than so much. Even though it's a shooter, it was so much different than other shooters that it really is a great game.
And did you know what they were doing the whole way along? Was it something that you guys could peek in and give them some help on? And did you know what to expect?
We have certain visibility into the projects, but it's really up to the licensee.
What Jay said is that licensees can show us their stuff or they cannot. I mean, there's a case you'll get a license, you'll go off completely in a vacuum, and then maybe, something goes wrong, and then they never contact us and we never know anything about it. Or you have the guys who are like, like the original Harry Potter game. One of those guys came and sat in our office for a week or two, and while we helped him optimize and figure out, he had questions about things, he'd just come and ask us. So our door is open to licensees, but it's completely their choice whether they want to show us what they're doing or not doing. There's no contractual obligation there, right? And it's completely their choice how much support they want to take or not take as well.